Raves, illegal underground dance parties in abandoned warehouses, transformation and spirituality through dance. A huge gathering of young people diverse in race, age, and culture. A place of harmony, unity, community, and acceptability. Legal dance parties promoted and advertised to the trend-following teenage market. A spiritual experience. Peace, love, unity, and respect. A religion, a way of life.
Parties are an escape. It's a great place to kind of bond with people, meet new people.
You'd walk in for me and it would be like, okay, everybody's here to do the same thing and we're just about to have a good time, you know, like that's all it's about.
It's a positive thing, you know? It's a positive thing. People going on, people dancing, people just grooving to the tunes and just having a good time. That's what it's all about.
The early rave scene was completely underground. The raves were simple. A DJ, a pair of turntables, a crate of records, a set of speakers, a location like a vacant parking lot, an abandoned warehouse, or an open field with a couple hundred kids. There were no permits, no flyers. It was simply word of mouth, and of course, they were free.
It was all about the vibe. It was really underground. It started off small. Like, you'd find an info line, you would phone that info line and say, go meet at this place. You go to that place and you would find out where you had to go from there, what number you had to call, you go to another place, and eventually you end up at the party.
It was like an adventure, like you didn't know where it was gonna be. Absolutely no, you had like one guy on the corner telling you, okay, you have to go here, follow these people, take this bus, go here, take the SkyTrain to this station and come back.
Like warehouse parties in like Detroit, where it was just like a wall of speakers and just free party.
Everyone could just kick back and just let all their frustrations out from work, et cetera, et cetera. I just party and have a good time.
The most important part of a rave is the music, but the music is controlled by the DJ. Spinning drum and bass, the DJ takes the crowd into a dark, sinister world of dirty bass and thick grooves filled with fast rhythms and percussion. Spinning trance, a dreamy world filled with layered, energetic tracks dipped in synthetic sounds, is created by the DJ. They are the purveyors of energy, giving the dancers euphoric visions and sensations through their unique skills of working the turntables.
For each track a DJ plays is like a representation of himself, so in a way it's kind of like you're sharing part of you.
You want to make people dance, otherwise why are you up there, right? For the most part I'm in my own world and I'm playing what makes me feel good, what makes me dance, because I love to dance. Shows when somebody gets up there and they're either up there because they want to try and, you know, escape the regular 9-to-5 by making some money as a DJ, or getting up there and they want to be cool and they want to be on the spotlight and show up in their shirt, whereas people that get up there and actually really feel and love the music.
I just like seeing people just dancing and getting into the music, feeling the music.
It's a high for sure.
Oh yeah.
It's a high. It's better than any drug out there, I'll tell you that.
There's a lot to say for when you get a response from the crowd, and a lot of DJs talk about it as well. And you just feed off it, it just multiplies your energy on stage, and that projects, it just goes back and forth. And it's really, it drives the whole thing.
Felt the need to share the music I liked with as many people as possible. So I started off with making tapes for friends and for people I knew from the school and everything. I live for the music. That's the most important thing for me. Without music, I would die, I guess. It's like an orgasm. You can't describe it, but it's really nice. It's not just one show. It's my whole life. It's full of excitement and still is.
For most of the kids, raves were a place to get away from all the stress in their everyday lives. The music carried them to another state of consciousness where they could lose themselves in the soothing rhythms. Emotionally, they would lose their inhibitions and attitudes to become more peaceful and friendly. Physically, they could express their newfound sensations through dance. Their minds were free to dream and imagine. It became a shared experience between all involved as they tried to reach a trance-like state through the throbbing, repetitive beat of the music, losing all abandonment. Feeling free and feeling the music was all they needed to catch the vibe, a positively unifying groove, almost religiously.
This is party music. That's totally it. This is party music, and all other music, they don't party like they do party here.
The music is so different than any other music I've ever heard before. It doesn't have lyrics. It's all about what you interpret the music as for you at that moment.
For me, it's all about the tunes, you know? I think the nicest thing for me is when you got a good tune and you just feel it hit you right here and you know it almost brings you to tears. So that's the best feeling.
It definitely, to me, would set me off in an emotion that I couldn't do with any other music, you know? Like, it's beyond anything else.
You'll hear a certain track and you'll just want to get up and dance no matter what. Like, you know, you can be fully straight and want to get up and dance because it's the energy, the music, and the people as well.
It's all about the music. It's uplifting, you know. You listen to any band you like, you know, it's obviously there's that feeling of, I don't know, happiness, and just put a smile to my face.
For others, synthetic drugs such as ecstasy, special K, and crystal meth are used to enhance their experience. Affecting the dancer's body by speeding up their metabolism, these drugs give them the energy to dance all night and chase the beat. The music flows right through their bodies, giving them an amazing sensation. Their minds escape into a carefree existence. Marijuana and mushrooms are the drugs of choice for the laid-back partygoers, wishing to alter their mood and bring themselves to a deeper level of consciousness.
There's not more you need to say. It's a sexually pleasing experience. It's releasing the tension. It's, it's taking you to another place, and it's ecstasy, I mean, that's what it is.
As much as I hate hearing it, you know, the love is in the air, you know, but that's what it did, you know, everybody wanted to touch everybody.
But I mean, it's fun, it's like, it's all perspective and all the way you take it. Like, you could either be totally freaked out by this, or you could just enjoy it.
My opinion, and it's opinion shared by many of the other police departments, that the events exist primarily for the taking of drugs. There wouldn't be that many all-night dance party events because it's primarily a sound and light and sensation thing, and the two work hand in hand.
You can say, yeah, drugs are bad and people shouldn't be doing drugs, but the thing is, people are doing drugs, and no, drugs aren't bad as long as you know what you're doing and if you're using drugs for the right reason. You use them to learn, you use them to grow and evolve as a human being.
At the end of the day, these parties are about the drugs until you get to the level where you can enjoy the music and the party without the drugs.
Raves truly are about the music, and the drugs are an unfortunate stigma and an aspect to them. In fact, I like to say that we're at greater risk of being hugged than we are of getting hit. Thank you.
Today, the raves are more complex. State-of-the-art sound, light, and video systems are used to produce a high-class show. Multiple high-powered speakers, lasers, light effects, strobe lights, psychedelic slideshows, and computer-animated videos are used to enhance the raver's world. Permits and insurance are bought. Vendors selling jewelry, candy, water, and anything else that would appeal to these kids show up more and more. Posters and flyers with intricate graphics advertising the rave inhabit clubs and record stores. Thousands of kids attend. Tickets range in price from $20 to $50, and there are always more at the door. Teams of security guards and undercover police are hired to control the crowd. They're advertised and commercialized, with corporations fighting for sponsorship. The scene has drastically changed. It's gone mainstream.
When it's commercial, you have these venues that you can stay at all night, and it's all organized for you. And, you know, there might be drugs, but at least it's all in one place, and it's not an underground culture where the dangers are more pervasive, so to speak.
Security and first aid are really key. A full search, a pat down and bag search is the first kind of line of defense.
My personal view on the whole rave scene is not a public, shouldn't be an announcement going around.
It's not necessarily us that's going mainstream, so DJs are going mainstream. I mean, DJs nowadays are costing more and more.
I guess it's the parties have gone a little more commercial and mainstream, so it doesn't seem to be more about, it's more so the vibe.
The smaller tight scenes are always good, you know, when you know a lot of people and you know what's going on. But I mean, the big scenes are good too, because everybody's getting on it and everybody's just raging away.
These once secret all-night dance parties have turned mainstream and a whole new generation of kids are going. The feeling of being at a tight-knit underground rave is almost gone. Old schoolers complain that this new crowd doesn't understand or even want to learn about the original inspiration for throwing a party. Others feel they've lost the special unknown haven to clubgoers and trendy kids who make raves too commonplace and destroy the edge. However, for most people, the thrill of being at a party will never be lost.
They don't necessarily go for the music. They're attracted to why everyone else is attracted to it, you know, that kind of thing. And that's kind of like the commercial vibe. Not really there because you want to go there for the music or, you know, that kind of, not for like personal enjoyment, more like going there because it's like a big bar.
I think a lot of people who go to the parties now and listen to the music don't really know the history.
As much as it is being stereotypical, you know, you get the bar crowd and you got this crowd, right? And I see a lot more bar crowd coming here, and I find people here are a little more respectful to each other.
If you don't like the vibe and you think there's too many bar stars or weekend warriors or whatever, then you can go around the corner to some underground spot where that's invite only.
I do a show in a basement mentality that, you know, I want a big production with big headlining DJs. You know, I want people to come for the show. I don't want people to come because it's an all-night dance party unless there's nothing to do.
Essentially, the fascination and interest in raves has grown very large and there is no turning back. However, since mainstream corporations and other large publications have taken hold of this craze, many kids might be discouraged to go to a legitimate, supervised dance party. But the excitement of finally getting to an underground party will always be there.
I felt like I was two at my, you know, very first birthday party that I can remember or whatever, you know. It was just like, you know, like this, you know, and it was just, I was with friends at the time, and it was just like, oh, you know, like, it was an amazing experience, definitely.
Well, it's sort of like order out of chaos, or, you know, controlled chaos. There's all this diversity and all these freaks, and they all come together to the same groove.
I felt one with the music, you know. I danced all night, and it was just unreal, unreal situation.
Vibe for me is really positive. It's going in the right direction. I'm planning on going a long way with it.
Searching all night, finally discovering the spot. Walking in with the music thumping and the DJ on point, spinning the hardest techno. The crowd going off, creating a euphoric vibe throughout the air. All the while knowing you're not supposed to be there having this much fun. Underground raves are still being held and still going strong. The rave scene will never die, and the underground experience will fight to survive. Every generation has a counterculture and a movement to call their own. Ours is raving, and our music is electronic.